Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Come on. Everybody all right tonight?
Amen.
All right. One. I'm finna turn on the bear. Miss Evelyn, good to see you.
Amen.
All right.
Amen.
Did you drive?
I drove.
She did.
Get what fog, get it what rain.
Yeah. Good, good.
Amen.
Been missing you.
Before
I turn on the bear, I just want to make this about Jerry Crider. He's at home.
Amen.
He did test on. He did not have no heart attack and all them rumors that some people's got. I made mention Sunday. He did not have no heart attack, but his problem now is his kidneys. His kidneys aren't working about 20%, so if they don't get his kidneys up, he's going to be on dialysis. They had him on it because it got down to like 9%, but they're up to 20%, but that's still, he's got a long way to go on that. But as far as the heart attack, he's fine. He done a stress test. He walked on the machine and everything. Didn't have no problems. He's eating. He just going to be a while before he can go back working on cars and in the shop and all. But only thing right now that really need to pray about is his kidneys, because that's the thing that's really got him bothered. And all that was because of that infection. That infection thing going around is a lot worse than people think it is, and it's really, that's what caused all his problems.
And he got that MRSA on top of that.
And then on top of that, he got that MRSA from the scratch he had, and that comes from the hospital more than I said. But anyway, that's a different ball game right there. But just keep him and his wife in your prayers. If you get an opportunity, give him a call. They just live right up the road here. But she said everything's fine. Just they're going back to the doctor and just hoping his kidneys will keep picking up some. So that's the thing on that. So y'all really just keep them in your prayers.
Alrighty, who else?
Look, Sam. Come here.
Yeah. Grandma.
Go for it.
Grandma.
Drummer, okay. Remember Mr. Jeff? Miss Evelyn?
Y'all pray for me and for 50. Dickie's got to have surgery Monday. They didn't get all of her cancer, and they got to go into the muscle inside of her eye. And they said they'd probably have to do another surgery to get her eye where it would open and close. She's going to have it done in Savannah, so you have to pray for her.
Miss Geraldine?
Keep remembering my granddaughter, Lucy.
Pray for Timothy and not Timothy, Kim. Her blood sugars are running really high, and Kaden is teething. So, pray for them. They're both not feeling well.
And we've asked prayer once before for one of my cousins up in North Carolina who has lung cancer. She's been going through all the treatments, and it's taken a toll on her. Then I found out day before yesterday, that her mom now has colon cancer and has chosen not to take any kind of treatments for her. So, remember that in prayer. John?
I went today and got my nerves burning my back, and I'm hurting. Y'all remember me in prayer.
Amen. John?
Continue to keep me and my family in prayer, my unsaved children and grandchildren.
Amen. Also, my cousin was in the hospital, had the bleeding on the brain, broken ribs. He is home. He's doing a lot better.
Amen.
Bobby?
Keep pressing your pressure. Went back to the pain clinic, and she just wore out just like me. So ain't that nothing new for her. I mean, I'm sorry, you know what I mean, but you got arthritis. They said your back, so you know what it is. So keep pressing your pressure too.
How about we got a customer down in Albany, Georgia. I know just a couple of weeks we were down there working, and there was still a lot of people still having to stay in motels because that the storm that blew through then. And the utility companies were working here every single day of the week trying to get it back up. And they just had this one, it just went through there, rolled through there and tore a bunch of stuff. So they never got over the last one. So that boy told said, I'm sorry. He said, he called me back at the end of the day on his cell phone. He said that, you know, the phones at the plant, they were just not working. I said, well, I understand that. So, I mean, the people got a lot going on down there. It's just going to take a little while to get back up and going.
Oh, remember us, and Tommy and Elaine will be traveling late tomorrow night and be back on Monday. So, give us travel mercies. Who else? All done? Let's all stand. I'm sure we all have some unspoken requests. And William, would you lead us tonight, please?
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, all the requests that we got tonight, Lord, bless all the people and heal them so they can get around, Lord, and lead us through the service and be with us and lead and guide us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Somebody give the Lord a hand clap. Don't forget Sunday's out dinner too. We got folks out of town, so we need all the help we can get. So somebody that ain't here, give them a call or something, because we need butter beans and cornbread and something to drink, if nothing else. But keep
that. You gotta be surviving, though.
Something ain't gonna be here. We need all the help we can get.
Well, what else goes with butter beans?
Onion.
Mayonnaise and cornbread.
No.
Just the cornbread.
I think he'd do without the mayonnaise bear.
That ruined his appetite, didn't it? Elaine done you a favor. She took the mayonnaise away from Tommy at dinner, wouldn't let him bring it with him.
Hey.
All right, y'all. Stand up and help us sing. We're on page 177.
Are you lost?
Have you been to Jesus' father's place? Are you lost in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully dressed in Jesus' doubt? Are you lost in the blood of the Lamb? Are you part of your heart in the blood? In the soul, in the blood of the Lamb? Are
Once like a bird in prison, I fell in love with the free. He's my bread. When I'm hungry, and He's my shelter from troubled winds. He's my anchor in life's ocean, but most of all, He's my best friend. Jesus washed me out of my sins. He brought life like I've never known. He's my life in a world of darkness, and to me the reason to go on.
Tonight, as we come upset over there about something.
Yeah.
I've been there just a little bit.
He'll be all right.
But tonight, we just gonna start back with our services on Wednesday night. When people ask, and I'm so happy, CJ, sitting back here.
Yes, sir.
He came here years ago when we first came up here, and I lived right up the road there, and he called me a few days ago, and God had been dealing with him. God called him into the ministry, and he'd been doing a lot of stuff for the past few years, and he said, I want to make this my home, and I want to do something for God.
Amen.
And I tell you what, it's a joy when anybody will make their mind up and say, look, I want to just do what God wants me to do.
Yes.
That is a joy. That makes more joy to me than anything, knowing that somebody is serious about, you know, doing whatever God leads them into. And we're so fortunate tonight, but we're so thankful. And he said, you know, I'd ask him, did he want to speak? He said, I was going to talk to you about that. You know, so God is moving and God is touching hearts. But tonight I want you to give your full attention to him tonight, and just let God have his way with whatever is going to give his testimony tonight, or whatever God's laying in his heart. But everybody say, God bless Brother CJ tonight.
God bless Brother CJ.
Come on,
man.
Tell a little bit about my testimony, where I came from, and how I got saved, and how I got into the ministry. I was saved in Easter of 1999 in Dawsonville, Georgia, at Church of God of Prophecy up there. And I was a member there for till about 2004-ish when we moved up here. And we came up here and been to a lot of different churches, but I think God did that for me for a reason, because he called me to call out false doctrine. And false doctrine is big, is going through this nation big time. And one of the main false doctrines at this time is universalism. And universalism is where everybody's going to be saved.
Right.
And that is false. And you got to discern and know the scripture to know that that's false. They believe that even Satan himself will be up there in heaven. So, and some of the church, main churches in this world are going towards that doctrine. And so, we even had some here in Congress do that, believe it or not. But I want to take you to 2 Timothy chapter 4 and verse 3, right quick, and then we're going to go turn to John chapter 10. But I want to take you to 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 3. And that's like my ministry's main calling. And 2 Timothy 4:3, chapter 4, verse 3 and 4 says, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. They shall turn away from their ears the truth, and shall be turned into fables. And that's what universalism does. It turns truth and turns it all into fables. Whatever we know from back when we was little about the Bible, they turn it around to be something else. They'll take the same scriptures that you were taught and act like it's irrelevant,
right,
and do it in a totally different way. But what is sound doctrine? And it's the salvation of the sinner and the sanctification of the saints. Jesus is the answer for both. For people have an itching of ears is also those who go to for smooth and comfortable word. They don't like to be convicted by the Holy Spirit. We had to have the Holy Spirit to lead and guide us. And also, I like to, on that note, for those who follow false teachers, not only turn away their ears from the truth, but see it that the ears are always in a position such that they will never come in contact with the truth. That goes along with being convicted by the Holy Spirit. They don't like none of that. And I'm glad I'm part of a church that believes in the Holy Spirit, believes in the Holy Ghost, and we still believe and teach that here. So, for my main topic tonight, let's turn to John chapter 10. I love this verse in scripture, because it really helps us to stay on the narrow path. But John chapter 10, we're going to read from verses 1 through 16. Once I turn there. John chapter 10, verses 1 through 16. Verily, verily, I say unto you, he that entereth not by the door into the sheepfold, but climbeth up another way, is the same as a thief and a robber. But he that entereth in by the door is the shepherd of the sheep. To him the porter openeth. The sheep heareth his voice, and he calleth his own by his name, and leadeth them out. And when he putteth forth his own sheep, he goeth before them, and the sheep follow him, for they know his voice. A stranger will they not follow, but will flee from him, for they know not the voice of strangers. The parable spake Jesus unto them, but they understood not what things were which he spake unto them. Then Jesus said unto them again, verily, verily, I say unto you, I am the door of the sheep. All that ever come before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not hear them. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, shall he be saved, and shall go in and out, and find pastures. The thief cometh not but to steal, and to kill, and destroy. I have come that I might have life, and have it more abundantly. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for his sheep. But he that is the hireling is not the shepherd who owns the sheep, or not seeth the wolf coming, and leaveth the sheep, and fleeth. And the wolf catches them and scatters the sheep. The hireling fleeth because he is a hireling, and careth not for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know my sheep, and I know mine. As the Father knoweth me, even so I am the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. And the other sheep I have, which are not of this fold, them also I must bring, and they shall hear my voice, and they shall be one fold and one shepherd.
Amen.
There are some verses I'd like to look at right quick. One of them is the first verse. It says, I am the truth, and the man does not enter the sheep by the pen gate, but climb in some other way as a thief and a robber.
Amen.
So if you climb in from any other way, and I believe that's from different religions trying to get to Jesus, but are trying to get to God, but Jesus is the only way, you can't do that. They are a thief and a robber.
Yes.
Verse 3 says, the watchman opened the gate for him, and the sheep listened to his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads us out. Once you are saved and sanctified, Jesus knows your name. And once he knows your name, he can call you. He calls every one of us to be a voice in the wilderness. Verse 5 says, but they will never follow a stranger. In fact, they will run away from him because they do not recognize the stranger's voice. In order to do that, we must be led by the Holy Spirit. We must be in contact with the Holy Spirit and know the Holy Spirit so we won't be led astray. And that is easy to do in this day and time. So we must be constantly in the Holy Spirit and know the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I am the gate for the sheep. That is in verse 7. That's talking about Jesus is the only way for the sheep to enter in.
Amen.
And verse 9 says, I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved. It also talks about that in Acts chapter 4, verse 12. It says, it's right here. Acts chapter 4, verse 12 says, neither there is no salvation in any other, for there is none other name under heaven which is given among men, whereby we must be saved.
Amen.
Acts chapter 4, verse 12. And also it talks about that in Revelation chapter 3, verse 20. I'm giving y'all a lot of scriptures, but if y'all need some, I'll hand it to you after the service. But that's Revelation chapter 3, verse 20. It says, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man heareth my voice and openeth the door, I will come unto him and sup with him, and he will be with me." So that's there is connecting John chapter 10, verse John chapter 10, Revelation 3 and 20 are coinciding by saying, "I stand at the door and knock." We must be ready and ready to hear his voice and ready at all times. And one of the main verses on this scripture is John chapter 10 and verse 10. "The thief comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy." Those are the three things that the devil is known for. And he, if you're not in contact with the Holy Spirit, and he will easily do that. So we must be full of the Holy Spirit at all times and know where we stand in him. Another verse I like in this John chapter 10 is verse 12. "The hired hand is not the shepherd, who owns the sheep. So when we see the wolf coming, he abandons the sheep and runs away. And then the wolf attacks the flock and scatters it." This is through the NIV. I like the way it puts it. A little bit different, but it says there the wolf, I believe the wolf is Satan. And then attacks the flock is the church.
Yeah,
and then it scatters it, which I believe is the denominations. That's why we have so many denominations.
Amen.
And
yeah.
If we can all just, we all say that we worship Jesus, but you enter the church and you're like, do they really worship Jesus? Or are they worshiping something else? You know? You have to really be sure what they're calling Jesus. Because I've been to some churches where they don't even like the Holy Spirit.
That's right.
They don't even like the mention of the Holy Spirit. They can scream and shout and holler, but if you mention the Holy Spirit, they'll kick you out.
Wouldn't blow it.
And that's really scary. But verse 14 also says, "I am the good shepherd. I know my sheep, and my sheep know me. Just as my Father knows me, and the Father there, and I lay down my life for the sheep." Jesus Christ laid down his life for us, and we are to be able to lay our life down for him.
Amen.
Because the time is going to come, I believe it's shortly coming upon us, where we're going to have to stand up for Jesus.
That's it.
And we are going to have to maybe even lay down our own life. You've seen over there in other countries over there, beheadings. Christians being beheaded. I believe that's coming to the United States. And it's coming soon. So we must be prayed up, ready at all times for Jesus to come. And the enemy is driven to steal. And he also will take your life. And so that's why we have to be prayed up with the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is the key of living the Christian life, I believe.
Amen.
And people who don't believe in the Holy Spirit, I just pray for them. Because they're really missing out on a true Christian life.
That's right.
And I know this was a short message, but this is all he gave me to preach on tonight. But I believe it is essential that with all these different denominations and what they teach, we have to know what other denominations teach so we can help other people get out. It's not easy to get out on some of them, but I believe with prayer that people will come to the knowledge of the saving truth, be baptized with the Holy Spirit, speak them in other tongues, and sanctified, and that's the way of life. And that's what I believe and teach. And I appreciate this opportunity. This is all God gave me. So, if that's it, mind if I turn it over to you?
Thank you.
truth tonight, you know, and
Amen.
That sort of fed off of what I was talking about, you know, that we live in a world where people just want to hear what pleases them.
That's right.
And if you start talking about something that steps on the toes, they get upset and they'll fuss you out and leave the church and go find them another one, and they'll find out that the same way they'll leave that one. But the truth is, we got to go by what the Word of God says. And
Amen.
We got so many churches today and that, you know, they won't talk about something. They say, well, we don't want to start no argument. But the bottom line is, we got to preach the truth of God's Word.
Amen.
Just like that little church down the road there, you know, said that the pastor said that when he graduated from seminary, they told him, said, there's some things that you don't need to preach on because it'll cause confusion. Let me tell you something, there ain't anything in this Word right here that should cause us confusion.
That's right. Yeah.
The Bible don't say the truth will cause confusion. It says the truth will set us free.
That's right.
And so, you know, just because it, you know, you may go through that you don't understand it, we have to study the Word of God and find out, because we realize tonight that we've got to have the Holy Ghost. If you can't be saved tonight, you can't live for God without the Holy Ghost. Ain't no, there's absolutely no way. Because if we ain't following God and being led by the Holy Spirit, then we're following the devil. And the devil will come up with all kinds of things and ways us to follow him that'll take us from the truth of God's Word. So there's got to come a time when the church is willing. That song we sing, you know, I'll stand for Jesus. Regardless of what denomination teaches, regardless of what, you know, the world wants us to hear, we've got to stand for the truth, because we know that if we'll stand for the truth, then God will make a way in whatever situation that we find ourselves in.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. I truly believe that if we'll stand on the truth and we'll walk in the truth and we'll be that light to this lost and dying world, then God will begin to move in our life and we'll see folks touched. I mean, you know, you'll have folks begin to ask you questions when they see, you know, God using you. And you know, I was blessed to be able to go to that denominational church. And, you know, they said, we just want to know what, because we've seen how God has moved in your life, how God opened your blinded eyes, how God did your kidney thing, how God's done this, that, and other. And they told us not to teach on that. And you know, but said, you know, if God is moving, then we want some of that.
Amen.
I mean, hey, if God's moving, you know, because we know that, you know, this church, we realize that God is still a miracle worker.
Amen.
It ain't what man's doing. It ain't what the doctor, it's what Jesus Christ is doing in these last days.
Right.
And he told us that if we would believe that and we would walk in it, he said, the things I do, you'll do, and greater.
Amen.
Amen.
I mean, he gave that to the church.
Amen.
That's you and I tonight, that we could go out, he said, lay hands on the sick and see them recover. That we could, you know, see the prison bars open. We could see those that's shackled by sin and there seemed to be no hope. But God come in and God work a mighty miracle.
Amen.
We know God is still doing those things.
Amen.
Because there's still a few people that are willing to stand on the truth.
Amen.
And be that, say, that light to this lost and dying world.
Yes.
Right. So I pray tonight, glory to God, I thank God for Brother CJ and what God has called him to. And we know that he's got a long, long future, a long way to go to telling folks about, you know, look, God is still the same God
Amen.
The Bible talks
right.
about.
Amen.
You know, it ain't about all these other gods and things of the world that please us, but it's about being a true witness. And letting folks, you know, see Jesus in us.
Amen.
Let folks realize, glory to God, that, hey, there ain't no other way tonight. You can pray till you're blue in the face, but until you begin to pray in the name of Jesus, you'll never see anything happen. You can pray to be, you know, want to be saved and want this, that, and other, but until you begin to call upon the name that is above every name,
Amen.
Won't nothing ever happen in your life.
Amen.
So I'm so thankful tonight that we've got some folks that's still willing to stand and still willing to call out on the name of Jesus
Amen.
In the midnight hour, knowing Amen. That he'll always come to our rescue.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Give the Lord a hand clap. He'll always be there to hear and answer your prayer.
Yes.
I'll move and go to God. It seems like that there ain't nothing can happen. that I'll move for you and I'll bless you and I'll lift you up. I'll strengthen you. I'll give you courage to stand against all the wickedness of this world. I'll give you a wisdom to speak the right words that'll draw folks unto Jesus Christ. That'll draw them to the altar of repentance. Come on, somebody. Because I still believe that we got to repent. We got to be baptized. Our life's got to be changed. Everything about us that's ungodly has got to change if we want to make it tonight.
Amen.
I believe it not because just what I say, but what the Word of God says.
Amen.
Come on,
he
said the old things have passed away, the old man is gone, and the new man is going to be born. Come on. Glory to God. When we go down in the water in Jesus' name, we're washing away our sin, and we're coming up a new man. No longer doing the things that we used to do. No longer having to depend on this world of alcohol and drugs and all this kind of stuff, but truly depending on what God tells us that we can have.
Amen.
And I tell you what, he has proven himself to me. He's proven himself to many of you in this place tonight.
Amen.
So whatever you fight and whatever you dealing with, you know, we don't have to live a life of being defeated and going through hell every day, but we can rise up in the morning and lift our hands and say, thank you, Jesus. Because we know that he's still making ways for people tonight.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. He's still working things that we sit around and want to know, can it ever be worked out? Can it ever change? And we see God doing those things. Because there's still some folks that's willing to pray and trust in God.
Amen.
Still some folks that are called by his name. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Still some folks that ain't bowing down to the teachings of this world and those false doctrines that Brother CJ talked about, but they're still following Jesus.
Amen.
You can't go wrong with Jesus, church.
Amen.
Come on, I said you cannot go wrong with Jesus. He'll always be there for you. He'll always, like I said Sunday, he'll love you all the way to hell. Come on, you may die and go to hell, but he'll love you all the way to hell.
Amen.
Glory to God. That's how much God loves you tonight. That's how much he wants to be our Savior.
Yes.
He wants to be our shepherd.
Yes.
What the Bible said, the Lord is my shepherd.
Mm-hmm.
I shall not want. Come on, somebody. Even though you go through valleys and even though you go through tough times and even though you go through situations that you don't even understand, but you know one thing. He's got my hand. If he ain't got my hand, then he's carrying me through it.
Amen.
He'll always make a way for the church.
Yes.
If you believe that tonight, give the Lord a hand clap. Come on. So I pray tonight we'll take this word, take what Brother CJ said and what the Word of God said, but he gave you scripture. Glory to God. And this will, like I said, will make a difference in your life. I know some of you come tonight and say, well, I ain't feeling too good, this, that, and the other. Let me tell you something. Glory to God, the old body's weak, but the spirit's strong. And if we can put our faith and courage in this man named Jesus, he can turn that stuff around. Come on, somebody. He can take your feeling bad that you feel good. Let your spirit be lifted up. Glory to God. When you begin to lift up the name of Jesus. Come on, there ain't no other name tonight.
Amen.
You know, them other gods can't save you. Them Buddhas and Islam gods and all this stuff can't save you tonight. I've been watching these studies on TV and there's a channel on my TV and I don't know what it's called. But every night they have a different study on these different religions and on these different gods. And they go into detail and millions of people following these things. But there's one thing they can't never say. There's never been a miracle performed by none of those gods. There's never been salvation brought forth to the human man by these gods.
Right.
It's all been fantasy and things made up and like you said, you know, everybody's gonna be saved. My God, we had a preacher here in Conyers not long ago, got up in the pulpit with over almost 2,000 people in the congregation, stood behind the pulpit and said, everybody's going to heaven. Everybody's going to heaven. Ain't nobody going to hell. A week later he got up and said he was gay. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Lost everything he had. Lost everything he had because he turned his back on Jesus. And I'll stand and say, when you turn your back on Jesus Christ, then you in for a hard road.
Amen.
You in for a hard road, Lord God. And you will never be able to make it without him.
That's
So I pray that we keep our eyes on Jesus. Those songs used to sing over to you, you know, keep your eyes on Jesus. He'll never lead you astray. He'll never lead you down the wrong road. He'll never tell you a lie. Come on, somebody. Yeah. But he will lead you in the truth.
Yeah.
And he'll and he'll make a way for you.
That's right.
So I pray tonight that we'll take this word, apply it to our life. And let's don't be ashamed of the gospel.
Amen.
Somebody tell you what you believe, tell them.
Right.
Come on, tell them what the Bible says.
Amen.
Tell them what you're standing on tonight. Tell them the truth that you're standing on. That could be just what they need to hear, that their life can be changed.
Amen.
See, Jesus can take the worst of the worst, and if they'll just trust in his name, they can be changed.
Yeah.
You can take that one, glory to God, that's pushed God off for years and years and years, but they can call out on that name with a fervent prayer and a believing heart, and God will come in and save them and change every aspect of their life. It's just a prayer away.
Yeah.
So I pray that we can be that example tonight, and we can be that living lighthouse in this lost and dying world.
Amen.
That when they see us, they see Jesus. Come on, somebody, give the Lord a hand clap tonight. Well, we pray you be blessed tonight. We pray that whatever you're going through, whatever situation you face, that you'll turn it over to Jesus. And I pray that when we come back here this weekend, we'll come in with a praise in our heart. In fact, I pray that when you leave this place, you got a praise in your heart.
Amen.
I pray when you get up in the morning, you got a praise in your heart. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. If you keep a praise in your heart all the days of the week, then Sunday won't be a problem. Wednesday night won't be a problem.
Amen.
When you got a situation facing you, it won't be a problem. You'll still be able to lift your hands and praise God anyway.
Amen.
Praise your way through the storm. Come on, somebody. Praise your way through the hard time. Praise your way when the devil's knocking on your door. And let him know that greater is he that's in me than he that is in the world. That's what it's going to take in these last days. Church, we've got an opportunity. We've got an opportunity to reach multitudes of people. And we've probably got a bigger opportunity now that there's been a change in the White House because we've got Jesus back.
Amen.
Come on, somebody.
Amen.
We moved the devil out, and maybe not all the beliefs that we believe, but we've at least got to the point where the Bible is something that, glory to God, that's welcome. The Bible we know tonight is what? It is the Word of God.
Amen.
It is Jesus Christ. Come on, somebody.
Amen.
In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. The Word was God. The Word was manifest. And Jesus Christ came to this earth as God in the form of a man.
Amen.
To seek and save that which was lost.
Amen.
So we've got an opportunity. We ain't got time to give up on nobody. But we got to pray and believe and trust God. And I pray tonight that every one of those that's sick tonight, that we can trust God, that God's going to move and bring healing to them.
Amen.
I believe we serve that God tonight.
Amen.
To everyone that's going through difficult situations, that God can move. To that family that's busted up tonight, and I ain't calling no names, but we're going to trust God that God can move in, and God can make everything that's messed up, he can make it right.
Amen.
To that young lady that's fighting for her life, dealing with this sickness and illness, that we can bind together and trust God, that God's not he's going to move, he's already moved. Lord, now we just going to receive it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
To that those in this church is hurting tonight, Lord God, their bodies are in pain, and maybe they can't walk like they want to walk and do the things they want to do. We're going to trust and believe God that according to his word, come on somebody,
amen,
that we can see them walking upright and doing what they need to do in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Come on, God ain't no respect a person. We'll trust him and we believe him. He'll make a way for us.
Amen.
I believe that with all my heart tonight, glory to God. I tell you what, I believe it till I drop dead, then I'll believe it when I'm on the other side. Because it's always going to be the truth. And the truth will set us free tonight.
Amen.
But we love you tonight. We thank you, Lord God, for coming out here on a Wednesday night. Like I said, remember those Let's see, remember Sister Evelyn, her eye situation, you found out anything, when they gonna do anything?
Nope, I hadn't called me or nothing.
All right, we got a knife in yonder, and, might get them glasses back with him for a second, and cut a little piece off, sticking her eyeball away. God can make a way, in that situation.
He made a way for me to be here tonight.
Amen. Yeah, that surprised people. Somebody asked, I said, I don't know, she can't, in a hard drive at night, anyway. There she come walking. Amen. God will make a, see, that's a miracle right there.
Amen.
That's a miracle right there.
Amen.
So, you know, God knows what he's doing, so, like I said, we just got to keep trusting God and believe God for those families tonight. That's, you know, some families going through some terrible situations tonight. People that you know, people that you know, and people part of this church that the devil's got into the to their families and to their lives, and is bringing all kind of hell and everything else against them. But I tell you what, I believe the prayer of the righteous. Come on, somebody, the prayer of the righteous tonight can move and set them free of everything that they face tonight.
Yeah.
And I'm trusting God, because like I said, I know my God works. I know my God don't fail tonight.
Amen.
So I pray that we continue to pray and seek God in these situations. Like I said, don't forget Sunday. Please be here. I know we got Baron David and Tommy Lane won't be here. Jessica and Chris and them's going to be gone. So we need all the help we can get. So everybody, you know, please be here and help us to, you know, to worship God. And then the servant meal this week. And I pray that when everybody gets back, we all stay in town for a little while and we can get together and get back like it needs to be, and all us worshiping God together in spirit and in truth.
Amen.
And see God begin to move miracles and do some mighty things here in this church. Because God has blessed us over the past 11, 12 years in this place and 7, 8 years in another place. And God ain't through blessing church.
Amen.
And we trust that he's going to continue to bless, and he's going to rise up a people that be planted and firm in his word tonight. Let us all stand tonight if we can. Father God, we come to you tonight in Jesus' name. God, we thank you for you, for the one you've called, Lord, to bring forth your word tonight. God, we pray, God, as a family of believers that, God, you undergird him, Lord, and give him the words to say, and God, help him, Lord, to just stay on that straight and narrow path.
Yes, yes.
I pray, God, that you take and bless him, Lord, in everything he says and does. I pray, God, you touch those that are sick tonight, those that are going through, and bless them and bring healing and bring salvation, Lord. Bring deliverance to them tonight. To those that's busted up, God, bring a healing that you can bring them back together, Lord, and let them plant their lives and their families on your word. I pray, God, Lord, that you help us, Lord, to always strive to do what you called us to do, and not trying to please the world and not trying to please the flesh, Lord, but just trying to do what you've told us to do, Lord, and doing it with every ounce of being that we have. Because we know, God, that you'll always make a way for us. I pray, God, that you'd touch every need in this place tonight, God. So many needs, and we just pray that you touch it, God. You bless it, Lord, and you protect this building that we worship in. We thank you, God, that you've always met our every need. You've always made a way for us, God. And we know, God, that you ain't through. And I pray you just continue to move and bless and be with us, God. Be with those that's as we leave this place tonight, God, put your angels about and protect us, Lord, in our cars, Lord, on our way home. And Lord, touch those people down in South Georgia tonight, God, that's struggling, God. We got family down there. We got friends down there, Lord, that's really struggling and going through. And God, I pray that you'll move and, Lord, supply every need that they may have tonight, God. And God, let our prayers be heard by you. And God, you begin to move in a mighty way. And then if they don't know you tonight, God, that through this storm and through this trial that they're facing, that they'll come out of God realizing that you are real, that you are true, that your word is true and faithful tonight. And I pray, God, that you just be with us in everything we say or do. Forgive us what we failed you so many times. And we'll be careful to give you all the praise. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Can somebody shout amen tonight?
Amen.
One more time. Lay them on that door, my Bible, and I'll set them up there in case you need them.
No, Samuel, no! Don't you dare touch that, that is not yours. You won't, no. You touch that, whoop your butt. That's CJ's, you do not touch it.